We believe that number is going to go to 100. So that's almost a 40-fold increase in the next 5 years.
Cathie Woods is the CEO of ARK Invest. She's most notably known for her bullish prediction with Tesla stock. She's also invested well in Square, Roku, and CRISPR Therapeutics in 2020, resulting in 150% gain in her innovation ETF just that year. This has led a lot of attention into ARK Invest and their disruptive innovation strategies. Most people, including myself, have watched Tesla skyrocket over the past few months and want to know what the next big disruptive innovation opportunity is. Well, guys and girls, I've been doing a lot of research and I think I found this next opportunity. Cathie also believes that this industry is going to provide more good than even Apple does.
Apple is a $1 trillion market cap company, and it's changed our lives, and we love our Apple phones and AirPods and watches. But the Apple is not curing cancer. It's not curing disease. These companies, we believe, will.
Now, what Cathie is talking about and what we are going to be talking about in this video is genomics. Now, in an interview with Bloomberg, Cathie had this to say.
Tesla is still in the running, but I would have to say the biggest upside surprises are going to come from the genomic space. And that's because the convergence of DNA sequencing, artificial intelligence, and gene therapies, importantly, CRISPR gene editing, are going to cure disease. That convergence is going to cure disease. Now we have real science and technology surfacing the mutations in our genomic profile. And as they surface those mutations, what do we see? We see the earliest manifestations of disease. And now, with the combination of artificial intelligence and gene editing, we're able to both anticipate diseases and cure them potentially. Beta thalassemia, we're seeing it, sickle cell disease. We even think it will work in diabetes, which is where most if you look at the largest category of spending year to year in healthcare, it's diabetes.
Now, the first thing that you need to know is a genome is an organism's complete set of DNA, which includes all of its genes. Now, genomics focuses on the structure, function, evolution, mapping, and editing of genomes. Now, an easy way to think about this is to imagine a puzzle, and the puzzle pieces are your genomes. What mapping does is it tells you where the puzzle pieces go and how they fit together, and what editing would do in genomics would be if your puzzle pieces weren't fit right, they would cut the pieces up, they would morph them together and make sure they fit. So if your body was just a giant puzzle, then genomics would be figuring out that puzzle. Now, what Cathie talks about a lot is the mainstreaming of gene editing, which would be huge for the medical field and for people with genetic diseases and disorders. And she gives an example of this right here in this clip.
One of the first one being pediatric blindness. A baby born blind, you correct that programming error, the baby can see, it works in mice, it works in non-human primates. If it works in human beings, think about what the reaction will be. Well, we'd prefer to be in the stocks before that reaction.
Now, Cathie and ARK Invest's early exposure into the genomics sector has paid off really well. As you can see on the chart here, back at the bottom of the pandemic and the market crash, ARKG was sitting around $25 a share, and now it is currently up over $100 a share. Now, Cathie and ARK Invest are up to something special. How special? Well, I'm going to talk about their predictions that they just released in their new Big Ideas research report. And I'm also going to show you guys why I think genomics is huge for the future. Now, first, I want to talk about a huge breakthrough that happened with one of ARKG's major holdings, CRISPR Therapeutics. Now, CRISPR Therapeutics uses their Cas9 gene editing platform in order to make precise and directed changes to genomic DNA. Now, what CRISPR's done that's so fascinating is they actually did a gene editing experiment on this woman named Victoria Gray. Now, Victoria suffers from sickle cell anemia, where your red blood cells are crescent-shaped. And she said this causes pain around all of her body. Now, what doctors did is they removed bone marrow from her cells and edited a gene inside with CRISPR-Cas9, which hopefully would produce a protein that could alleviate the complications of sickle cell anemia. Now, since then, it's said that she's been doing super well, but we're going to have to continue to wait and see if there are any complications down the road. Now, there's either long read or short read sequencing, and ARK Invest believes long read sequencing will grow at an annual rate of 82% from $250 million in 2020 to roughly $5 billion in 2025. So one reason why ARK believes that this is going to improve significantly is because, one, the reduction in price. So ARK believes in something called Wright's Law, which it states for every cumulative doubling of units produced, costs will fall by a constant percentage. Now they believe this will be the case with long read sequencing. As you can see by this graph, they think it'll be sub $1,000 by 2023. Now this goes hand in hand with another reason why ARK is so bullish, is that they believe long read sequencing is more efficient. As you can see from the graph, short read sequencing provides more base accuracy but less completeness, and long read sequencing provides less accuracy but more completeness of the genome. Now ARK believes with the decrease in price of long read sequencing, this is going to effectively have companies and people choose long read sequencing over short read sequencing if their prices are equivalent. Now this is going to benefit a company called Pacific Biosciences, which is actually the third top holding in the ARKG ETF. Now Pacific Biosciences is up a significant amount this year, but if we can see an 82% revenue increase year over year with this company, I can imagine that this stock is going to continue to skyrocket, which in turn is going to skyrocket ARKG. Now this next part right here is extremely important for investors and human life in general. Now liquid biopsies is a blood sample test that is extremely important to help monitor and track cancers early. Now ARK believes due to innovative technologies that's pushed the cost of multi-cancer screening from $30,000 in 2015 to only $1,500 today, and they believe that it can go to $250 in 2025. Now ARK also believes the multi-cancer screening market should scale to $150 billion in the United States, and it could potentially save up to 66,000 lives per year. Now if ARK is right about this, that would be a scientific breakthrough and just incredible for the human race. Gene therapy and editing trials have increased fivefold since 2010, and there's only 10 FDA-approved gene therapies right now, but ARK believes 170 gene therapies are likely to be approved within the next 10 years, so that is a 17 times increase. Now when it comes to disruptive innovation, ARK has been on a roll, and they've almost never been wrong. 3D printing, artificial intelligence, electric vehicles, financial tech, and even genomics and DNA sequencing. They've produced massive gains for their investors in 2020, and I do believe they're going to repeat that in 2021. Now, of course, this is not investment advice. I am just presenting you guys some big opportunities. Now, if you want to diversify your portfolio and you are not sure which genomics company you should be investing in, then I would definitely go with ARKG. It's an actively managed fund by ARK Invest, and they are updated selling, trimming, buying positions every single day. Now, as the intelligent investors that we are, we know that historically ETFs cannot perform this well over a long period of time. But personally, I do believe in the genomic sector within the next 10 to 15 years, and I do believe in Cathie Wood and ARK Invest. Now let me know what you guys think about this genomic revolution. Do you think it's as big as ARK Invest thinks? Do you think the revenue is going to increase by 82% for long read sequencing over the next 5 years? Because if it does, that is a huge investing opportunity. But let me know your thoughts down below, because I am new to genomics. I've been researching as much as I can, but of course there's a lot of stuff that I don't know, so I'd love to talk about it with you guys in the comments. And of course, if you did like this video and you want to see more, make sure you subscribe. We are on the road to 1,000 subscribers. Other than that, I will see you guys in the next one.